Hello, I'm Professor Wohl, and today I'll be discussing how to integrate security into the continuous integration process. So we're talking about a DevOps environment. You have developers writing source code. Whenever they're finished with a piece of code, they commit it to the source code repository, and then the build automation system kicks in. The build automation system takes the source and creates an application server, deploys the code to the application server, and then it activates the first round of integration tests, which are typically unit tests that can happen within an hour to test whether the new functionality is doing what it's supposed to. Then, typically every night, the build automation system takes the code developed by all the developers that day and activates a deployment onto the test environment of all the code that was generated that day, and runs a nightly suite of tests. This is the CI2 cycle of tests, typically integration tests and more heavyweight testing to test that the functionality of the application as a whole is doing what it's supposed to. And all this keeps going every day. Now let's introduce the notion of what happens when you need security. So when does that happen? If the developers in their development cycle actually change the application so that it requires access to another network resource, let's say this other database, if they do that, and the build automation system is not aware of this, then when the code is deployed to the test environment, it will fail the tests because there is a firewall separating the application server in the test environment from the test database, and that firewall over here was not updated to allow the requested traffic. So we get a failure. How can we avoid this failure? Well, my suggestion is to maintain within the source code repository this additional descriptor file, which I call the connectivity descriptor file. This is a file that the build automation system can recognize. So whenever a developer adds functionality, adds code to request this connectivity to the extra database, they would also update the descriptor file, and now the build automation system can be aware of this change and take action. The second challenge that we need to address now is, well, how will the build automation system respond to this change? After all, the build automation system typically is not allowed to make changes to firewalls. First of all, it might not have the technical capability to do so. And secondly, even if it does, making changes to firewall policies typically requires governance. The security teams have to approve this. The changes have to be documented. They have to be ready for audit. So it's not typically acceptable to have a build automation system make direct changes into a firewall without oversight. To address this challenge, in fact, both challenges, both the technical and the procedural, we introduce this system over here, the Network Security Policy Management System. This is a system that typically is not part of the build automation. It's used by the security teams and firewall operations teams to manage the firewalls of the whole estate, and it is technically able to communicate with firewalls and make changes to them. It is also equipped to handle all the audit and governance requirements and documentation requirements that security infrastructures require. So the missing piece is for the build automation system to make a call to the APIs provided by the Network Security Policy Management System. And this API call would trigger the change that is necessary, but implemented through the Network Security Policy Management that makes sure that all the governance requirements are still met. So at the end of this, once you deploy and activate this connectivity between the build automation system and the Network Security Policy Manager API, and also introduce this connectivity descriptor in the source code repository, you get end-to-end deployment in the DevOps methodology while doing everything completely automated, including making changes to the security policies in the firewalls, but without losing any kind of governance requirements that you're subject to. Thank you for your attention. See you next time.